Hi, Assalamualaikum to Dr. Ani Syazwani. My name is from Syifa, Mazlan, and I will be the first presenter for this group presentation where I elaborate a bit more about local government. Malaysia is a multi-ethnic and multi-religious country. Its royal charter was established in 1957 to establish a monarchy system. This country has three levels of governments, which are the federal, the legislative, and the judiciary. In Peninsula Malaysia, the Local Government Act 1976 established the local authorities. The local government allows for the establishment of local government within a region or state. They are elected by people in the area they serve. The local government is also referred to as a civil service agency that serves as the Prime Minister or the municipality. Moving on to the concept of local government, the amendment's purpose would allow the local authorities to have more powers and responsibilities. Amendments and new legislations are proposed to give the local authorities more powers and responsibilities. The objective of this project is to study and implement the amendments and the new legislation proposed to local authorities. These are the local authority that manage the criteria and conditions that must be followed in order to complete the requirements in Malaysia City Council. Although the Local Government Act refers to two different types of local authorities, there are also four types of local government in Malaysia. The revenue of these bodies comes from various sources, such as non-profit funds and taxes. They also have responsibilities when it comes to public utilities. Aside from managing the basic infrastructure of the community, of a community, these bodies also have various other responsibilities such as revenue collections and waste management.
Hello, my name is Aimi, Najihah, Suhaimi. In this group assignment, we have selected Melaka Historic City Council. In Malay, we call it as Majlis, Bandaraya, Melaka, Bersejarah, MBMB, as the subject of our case study. First of all, for the background and the history of MBMB, the establishment began with the creation of Melaka in 1824 by Syarikat Hindia Timur, and it was known as the town and the fort of Melaka. Around the time, MBMB was administrated by the Committee of Assessors for Town Planning, Public Order and the Collection of Assessment Rates. Here shows the milestones for the background and history of MBMB in a brief. In 1824, the town and city of Melaka was established by the East India Company, which is Syarikat Hindia Timur. 1848, the provision for the establishment of municipal committees for United Settlement. 1856, the Municipal Commission was formed into a company with a continuous succession. 1888, the administrative boundaries were delineated. And 1977, the combination of the Municipal Council and the Central Melaka Rural District Council. 1984, the Central Melaka Municipal Council was renamed the Melaka Municipal Council. This is the MBMB logo, which is, it consists of six colors, namely blue, red, white, yellow, green, and black. The color on the logo is inspired by the color of the flag of the state of Melaka, and each of them has its symbolism, where various colors such as white, yellow, and blue found on the state emblem are the colors found in Malaysia's flag. So the blue color symbolizes the unity. The red color symbolizes the courage in upholding a dynamic administration. The white color symbolizes the purity, holiness, and noble character. The yellow color symbolizes the height of dignity. The green color symbolizes the Melaka city of green technology and also symbolizes the peace and beauty. And the last one is the black color is used for the typography for the words Historic Melaka City Council or Majlis Bandaraya Melaka Bersejarah. MBMB has many objectives, including matters of development of project planning, managing and maintaining public infrastructure, administration and taxation. In the matter of taxation, there are a few objectives that MBMB wants to achieve. The first is through the efficient issuance of licenses can further encourage business growth in the state of Melaka. Apart from that, the council's revenue can be generated through the collection of assessment tax and the council's asset management if efficient and effective financial management can be strengthened. Lastly, the implementation of the council's effective and integrity management system needs to be monitored consistently. That's all for me. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nurul Sahira binti Halim. Today, I would like to explain about power of MBMB. Melaka State City Council or MBMB have a power on development, planning and structure, management and standards. All land development procedure for development project based on the provision under the National Land Code 1965 KTM 56, Town and Country Planning Act 1976 Act 172 and Road Train and Building Act 1974 Act 133 also manage and maintain public infrastructure project. MBMB to plan, maintain and monitor quality public beautification and cleaning projects. Provide and supply logistical needs for the convenience and well-being of the citizen. Next, give a license and monitoring of the public health of city. Enforce the law and provide legal understanding in all matters of the council and monitor the implementation of an effective and integrity council management system. The Act allow MBMB the power to regulate first Local Government Act 1976, second Street Drainage and Building Act 133, third Town and Country Planning Act 1976, fourth Destruction of Disease Bearing Insect Act 1975, fifth Food Act 1983, sixth Road Transport Act 1987, 7 Rain Control Act 1976, 8 Districts Act 1951, 9 Food Regulation 1985. For the function of MBMB, firstly, they have a right to planning city development continuously and strengthen city function as cultural center, commercial, education and administration. 2. Make Melaka an advanced city, also build and maintain infrastructure development to fulfill social claim and improve people's standard of living and tourists. 3. Generate economic activity through commercial planning, industrial tourism and financial sector through integrated license policy. 4. Make Melaka as a garden in a city by planting trees and flowers in public longway and area with design, furniture, road lighting and pavement perfectly and orderly. 5. Ensure health and clean life by monitoring solid waste disposal sewage system and grass cutting perfectly and orderly. 6. Planning, coordinate and implementing program and social activities in effort promoting unite and harmony plural society. That's all from me. Thank you.
Slide. I'm Noor Syazwani will present about the source of revenue. The total amount of income earned by the sale of goods or services connected to the company's principal operations known as revenue. However, revenue is not earned by company or organization only, but revenue also needed for every government in the world to manage the financial in the country. Besides, the Melaka Historic City Council is the local government that governs Melaka City and the Melaka Tengah District, known as MBMB. The MBMB now receives revenue from a variety of sources, including taxes, compound license fees, rent, and others. For taxes, taxation is a major source of revenue for local governments since it is a mandatory financial charge imposed on a taxpayer, whether an individual or a legal corporation by a government. For example, property assessment tax and quit rent rates for residential in Melaka State. Next, there are several sources of revenue, which are assessment rates, licenses, rentals, government grants, car parking charges, planning fees, compounds, fines and interest, and also loan. In addition, for rental, MBMB are provided rent for public facilities such as hall, stadium, car park and another rent. For example, Tun Fatimah Stadium, MBMB Hockey Stadium, swimming pool, parking lot and many more. Furthermore, for the license and permits, Melaka Historic City Council, MBMB, is in charge of overseeing all business operation within its administrative boundaries. The Local Government Act of 1976 has given MBMB the ability to legislate and enforce licensing by laws in the MBMB region. For example, license and permit that sources of MBMB's revenue is temporary advertisement permit.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Ahmad Baihaqi and I will present on the rating. According to JPPH, assessment tax is a local government tax imposed on all types of holding. And basically, this tax will be paid twice a year. The first one is on 1st January to 28 February, and the second one is 1st July to 31 August. For the basis of tax, according to MBMB officer, MBMB and the other local authority in Malacca already changed its tax basis, which is, it started to use improved value since 2016. Before that, the basis is based on annual value. For rate of tax, every local authority has their own percentage of rates. For MBMB, the structure of rate that currently enforced is based on 2016 assessment rates that gazetted under the Malacca State Government Gazette on 17 December 2015. And in these slides, we can see that every type of holding has their own percentage of rates, and the rates of the holdings that located at the city is higher than the rate that located at the mukim or small city. For the calculation of tax, the main method that have been used by MBMB is the investment method, calculated net rental value per annum. And the formula is the improved value is multiplied by the percentage of annual rates imposed by MBMB. For the recovery of rates, there are four steps in Local Government Act. However, MBMB only practice two of them, which is from Form E until Form F. Firstly, if the tax is not paid within the time, the tax will be recovered after a notice to pay the arrears in Form E. And to settle the arrears within 15 days, the taxpayer will also need to pay the penalty, and the penalty and the amount of penalty imposed by MBMB is 10% of the tax. If the taxpayer failed to settle the arrears within 15 days, the warrant of attachment in Form F will be issued, and the owner also need to pay the warrant as much of 20% of the total arrears imposed by MBMB. For remission and refund of rates, MBMB used a formula to determine the amount of remission. The formula started with the amount of annual assessment tax divided by 365 days before multiplied by the amount of vacant days and the percentage of remission imposed by MBMB. For the percentage of rates remission, before COVID-19, the amount of percentage for all type of property is 25%. But after COVID, industrial and commercial changed to 50%. Last but not least, this is the example on how MBMB used the previous formula to calculate the amount of remission. If the total of annual tax is 400 ringgit, residential type and have 300 of vacant days, thus the owner will get around 98 ringgit of remission after put all of the information into the formula.
For conclusions, the federal government, state governments and the local governments are the three levels of government in Malaysia. The local government, on the other hand, is the lowest tier in the terms of administrations. In Malaysia, there are various types of local authorities, such as the district councils, the city councils and the municipal councils, the various functions of a local authority can be divided into four areas like environmental, public safety, social and governance. Lastly, the operational expenses of a local government are divided into two categories. The first is the development expenditure, while the operational expenses through the assessment tax, the local authorities can generate their own revenue. Therefore, it is particularly important to understand on how the rating and assessment tax is highly related to the operations of the local authorities. That's all. Thank you for your time for listening. Thank you.